I'm in Newham, one of the Olympic boroughs from last year, to visit Christine Ahorogu, someone I've really admired and watched her career over the years. She's got 3 global titles and she could do anything with her time, yet she has chosen to visit all the schools in her borough. And I really want to find out why. The Chobham Academy only opened in September, but it's the latest of the 150 schools that Christine has pledged to visit. What's more, it truly embodies the spirit of legacy as it uses buildings and infrastructure from the Olympic Village itself. Wow, this is an impressive school.
Good morning, everyone. I was born in Newham. I went to school in Newham. I'm from a big family. I've got 6 brothers and 1 sister. There's 8 of us. And we all went to school in Newham. So I've made it my personal mission to go around to all the schools and just to try and give them a really positive message, just to tell them that, you know, sometimes there's a big world out there, and if you just work hard, you can really achieve what you want to go out and achieve.
You are writing on the table.
You are writing on the table. Wow.
My idea behind it was you've really got to use the gains and push on, you know.
And build on that.
And build on it, exactly. Keep pushing on. Don't just sit and say, oh, they don't care about us and we're not going to do anything about it. Really use what the stories you got from the games to build yourselves up and go out and achieve great things. The most important kind of defendants of this legacy program are the residents themselves.
Absolutely.
Those are the ones who are going to drive it. Those are the ones who live there, who know what goes on day in, day out. They're the ones that have kids that go to schools. They're the ones that work in a borough. They know what the borough needs. So when we're talking about legacy, don't sit and wait for other people to put your destiny into place. You go out and say, this is what our kids need. And this is what we're going to do as parents, as residents, as business owners. This is what we're going to do for the borough. Schools I go to, I make no illusions about the fact that I did want to win. And I have got a silver, but I would have liked it to have been gold. The standard, I'm sorry, I'm not going to beat around the bush. I wanted to win gold. I didn't. I came with a silver. At the same time, I think it's recognising where I'd come from to get that. And I think now I look back on it, I think the silver meant more to me than the Beijing gold medal.
Wow.
Because of where I'd come from. I literally clawed my way out from a bottom of a bottomless pit.
Yeah.
That's what it felt like. I think it felt like every year was just not going right. Nothing was working. I always told myself that what I was going to do going into 2012 was that I would prepare myself the best way I can, and I'll defend my title with everything I've got. The one thing I really want to tell you is that, you know, go out there and dream big. Really go out and really set your standards high. With me, I'm never fully happy. Because it's what I do, I kind of have a responsibility to keep doing it. So it doesn't matter what I've achieved, that's not the point. The point is that this is what I've been put on this earth to do. This is my purpose, my calling. So I will keep on doing it until, you know, the time's up. So go out and enjoy yourself. Remember to dream big and keep looking after each other. Sure.